Yes, a very pleasant good morning, children. Today we are going to do a very important topic of your syllabus, that is application for job. It is a part of your writing skills, and application for job actually is a letter, is an application you write when you want to fetch a job, when you want to get a job. So in this application for job, you know, basically application for job is like self-advertisement. It's for employment purpose. And in this application for job, we talk about ourselves. If I want a job for some, you know, specific designation, then I'll be writing this application and it will be about myself. I'll be advertising myself. I'll be talking about my qualities, my qualification, my achievements, my strengths, and the references, right? So application for job, when you write it, maybe for examination purpose, or maybe in reality, if you write, you know, then it will be written in two parts. One is the cover letter and the other is the bio letter, which is also called as curriculum vitae or vitae or resume. So one is cover letter. Cover letter is exactly the formal letter which you write to the authorities. Okay, when you write, when you're seeking a job somewhere, then you will first write a formal letter, and formal letter will be followed by a bio letter. There are two things. Bio letter can be a part of your formal letter, or you can first write the whole letter, then it can be followed by bio letter, which is also called as curriculum vitae, or you also call it as resume. Right? So when we write the cover letter, its format will be the same as is in case of a formal letter. Let's again revise it. So it starts with, the cover letter starts with the address of, self-address, you can say. It's your self-address. And then afterwards, it will be followed by date. And it's followed by the address of addressee, that is the receiver's address. What you have to be very careful about, like when you write the receiver's address, then you must be very, you can start with the designation of the person whom you are addressing your letter. Designation, the name of the institute or of the department, name of the, and then the place, right? The receiver's designation, that department or institution, then finally the place. That is the receiver's address. After receiver's address, we write subject. Subject is to be written like application for the post of, okay? So it can be like application for the post of. For the post of, then whatever the post, whatever the exact, you know, post you are applying for, mention that. So don't write like applying for the post of, okay? Don't start with the gerund or the participle. Start with application for the post of. Remember this, please. After subject, we write the salutation. Salutation. Salutation is always usually like, you can either say dear, supposing it the receiver was the manager, dear director, this dear CEO, whatever. So you can say, you can address the, you can greet the this designation with a dear, or you, if you are very confident that the person is a male, you can say dear sir or dear ma'am, if you are very confident. But in case you don't know whether it is a man or male or female, then avoid writing dear sir oblique ma'am. That is a derogatory. We should not write like that. Better dear manager, dear editor, dear CEO, or dear director, whatever. So after the salutation, you know, we will start writing the content of the letter. Content of the letter. It will come So finally, when the content of the letter will come, this we are going to discuss in details. And finally, after the content has finished, there will be three paragraphs basically. Okay, let us first, after the content would finish, we will give it a complimentary close. And a complimentary close can be given like yours truly and your signature and your name, full name. Yours truly is, it's a complimentary close. You can end up like yours sincerely, yours truly, okay? Then your signature and then your full name. Very important, your full name, because sometimes the signatures happen to be the initials and they are not very clear. So the recipient should know who actually you are. After this name, you know, your cover letter has not finished. The very important segment is left. What will that be? After this, you'll be writing, leave a line, write down enclosures. Your this cover letter will be followed by, you know, biodata basically. So what the enclosures will be? Biodata. What other enclosures would be? Passport size photograph. What else you might be enclosing? Testimonials. Testimonials are your certificates and all. Okay, if there is something, you can also attach that. If you think like something else is also to be sent along with the cover letter, that also you can write over here. So with the cover letter, mention like which things have you enclosed with this cover letter. Number one, there will be biodata. Second, there will be your photograph. It can be a photograph. There can be your testimonials. Or what else? What extra thing you need to mention, send along with the letter? That you can mention. So this is the format of cover letter. Now we have to discuss like what is to be written in the content part, right? So we will be focusing upon the content part now separately, then we'll come to the biodata part. So content part, this I am going to rub. If you people have written, then I can rub it out. Okay, done, children? Okay. Okay, we are going to talk about the content. So content in the first paragraph, mention the reference. Give the reference from where you got to know about this advertisement. Got it? Like what was the source of your information of this post? Refer to the newspaper, dated. So when you give reference, then the name of the newspaper. Name of newspaper or other agency from where you got to know the thing, name of the newspaper, date, okay, and the post. So first of all, you will give reference to the newspaper, like from where you got to know this about this vacancy. Then you'll be also mentioning the date and post of post. So refer to the newspaper, the Hindustan Times, dated 3rd of January 2020, regarding the post of senior lecturer lying vacant in your esteemed institute. After the reference, you will offer your candidature. You offer your candidature. That's very important. So, reference to the newspaper, I offer my candidature for the above mentioned post. Right? So, why you offer the your candidature? Because you are a befitting candidate for this post. So you can mention in the very first paragraph, like with reference to the newspaper, this dated this, regarding the post of dash, I offer my candidature for this above mentioned post as I possess all the requisite qualities are required for this post. Right? So that is your first paragraph where you'll be giving reference and you'll be offering your candidature. And second paragraph is the most important one. In the second paragraph, you mention, you prove your candidature. Prove your candidature. Prove that you are a befitting candidate. And how can you prove this? Here you'll be talking about your you'll be talking about your qualification. So in the second paragraph, you'll be talking in brief about your qualification, experience, your strengths, and your achievements, and your goals. In brief. In the second paragraph, you'll be talking about yourself from the professional point of view. For example, your qualification, experience, strengths, achievements, and your goals. In brief. Remember, it's not be a big long story because you are going to enclose your bio data where these things will be written in details. In the cover letter, these things are to be written only in brief. In a very compact form, these things must be written. Right? After the second paragraph, third paragraph would come, which is also very, very important. So I'm repeating, first paragraph, reference and offering your candidature. Second paragraph about, second paragraph is like you are telling like why you are a suitable candidate for the post. In the first paragraph, you said that you are a befitting candidate for this post, you offer your candidature, and in the second paragraph, you prove it through your, these aspects, right? These mention, these things should be in very compact form. Okay, brevity is the soul of a formal letter, be brief. Then third paragraph would come. And third paragraph, children. In the third paragraph, like you reassert your candidature. Reassert yourself as a befitting candidate for this post. How will you say this? How can you do this? Like by saying like, sir, you are a very befitting candidate, you'll prove to be an asset for the company if you're given a chance. Right? If you're given a chance, you'll prove to be an asset to the company. Along with this, you can also mention if you'll be available for one-on-one interview anytime. So talk about your availability at any time if you're actually a job seeker. Okay, otherwise, if you are already very busy, if you want to say like you are willing to accept this job, provided you are given a chance of interview as per your schedule. So yeah, that also you can mention, but that is better. Like I'll be available for interview on any date, or I'll be available for interview on any Saturday of the month for one-on-one interview. Something like this you can mention. So talk about your availability. For one-on-one interview. Right? So third paragraph, and finally conclude your paragraph, third paragraph, or conclude your cover letter with the words like looking forward to a favorable response from your side. Okay, so show optimism. Conclude your letter with optimistic note. So fourth, you can say it as the last line of the covering letter. It is like concluding with a positive note. It's the last point of the cover letter. After this, the complimentary close would come. Yours sincerely, your signatures, and then your name that we've already discussed in the earlier. Format wise, we have discussed this was the content part. One thing more, children, which we can add before the last line. Before last line, you can also mention when you were reasserting your candidature, when you were talking about your availability for one-on-one interview. There also you can mention, like here, I'm enclosing my biodata, passport size photographs, and testimonials for your kind perusal. Okay, you can mention it here. Like here I'm enclosing, you talk about the enclosures here also in the letter. Enclosures for your kind perusal, P-E-R-U-S-U-A-L. Perusal means your kind reference, your consideration. So here I'm enclosing my biodata and other testimonials for your kind perusal. With this, and afterwards conclude the letter with a positive note like this, looking forward to a favorable response, yours truly, your signatures and name. With this, the cover letter will come to an end. But yes, after the complimentary close, I have told you earlier, you'll be writing the enclosures. Enclosures, this, whatever. Is that fine? Is that fine, children? Have you noted the things? Okay, then, yes. Now, what is left? Now, what is left? Raise hand to tell me what is left, what we have to discuss yet. Yes, Tanveer, you tell what we have to discuss yet. Unmute yourself.
First, complimentary close.
Yes, Pratik, complimentary close, there you'll be writing your name and all. Complimentary close means yours truly, XYZ, what your name is, right? After the complimentary close, we'll be writing the enclosures, biodata and all. Na, uske baad, do we have to do anything else? Kuch aur reh gaya hamara, bataiye. Yes, come on. This was only cover letter. Cover letter we have done so far. What is left now?
Biodata.
Yes, biodata is left now. Biodata is left. We told them in the cover letter that I am enclosing my biodata. Now, where is the biodata? That we will do now. Is that clear? So after the cover letter is over, we'll start the biodata on the next page. So on the top, we'll write biodata. I told you like biodata is also called as curriculum vitae or resume. So biodata is a complete, it's your complete personal information. So when you write a biodata, then remember we'll be covering up four parts. Number one, personal information. Second, qualification. Third, experience. Fourth will be achievements. You may call it as a miscellaneous box. Miscellaneous things will include achievements, hobbies, strengths, right? And after the experience, so this was 1, 2, 3, miscellaneous is 4, and fifth one, most important, is references. After references, we will write declaration. After declaration, we would write the place plus date. So this is the biodata. When we write personal, remember these on the broadly, you know, there are 5 points: personal information, qualification, experience, miscellaneous. When we talk about miscellaneous points, and we'll cover up achievements, hobbies, strengths. Then finally, fifth point, most important, is references. We'll be giving the reference of the people who are the gusted officers and under whom we have been there, either as students or as the workers. So these people should be the reference, should be the ones whom the prospective employer will can contact to know about ourselves. Then it is a declaration, like whatever I've written, this is all true. You'll declare this, like whatever I've written, this is all true, and nothing is wrong. And place, like from where are you writing this letter, and date of this letter's write-up. Okay, place, date. And with this, you know, your write-up will come to an end. That is the end of this biodata. Now let us see what is to be written for personal information. Now biodata, these are the points I've told you, right? But your biodata will be written like this. For example, this is your page. Biodata. So you can have the heading first point as personal information, name, age, date of birth, blood group, nationality, father's name, father's mother's name, and then finally address for correspondence, or correspondence address. So when you're writing these all points, name, X, Y, Z, age, 26 years, date of birth, it can be, for example, whatever your date of birth is, DD, MM, and year. Blood group, you can mention AB plus, whatever, nationality, Indian. Father's name, Mr. X, Y, Z, mother's name, Mrs. ABC. So see all these things in like this one go, and these all in this, you know, side. So kindly use a central alignment and give your biodata a nice look. Okay, number one, when you write something like this, then presentation matters a lot. The way you present your things, that happens to be very important. So this was the personal information. Afterwards, after this point, you can put this personal information in one box. Okay, that would give it a better look. After the personal information, you will write, our second point is qualification. Yes, when you write qualification, you can start from bottom to top. That is better. Okay, you can start from top to bottom. For example, your highest degree is post-graduation. Post-graduation in political science from Punjab University in 2018 with 87% marks. For example, either you can write like this, but the better way is you draw a table with different columns. First of all, degree, then it can be the board or university, then it can be year, marks obtained, percentage. And here you divide the whole thing: degree, masters, graduate, senior secondary, matriculation, like this. Right? So you can better divide your qualification in these points. It will look better. And try to go from top to bottom. Okay, write the highest degree first. Right, after the qualification column, we'll be starting with the experience part. And when you write experience, there also the point is, right now, where are you working? Okay, that also you can have a column. You can have columns like name of the institute, designation, and year or duration of your job. For example, you worked in Wipro India Limited as senior manager from 2019 to 2020, right? So like this you can mention. And also one more column you can have for salary withdrawn, like how much salary you had there, you can also mention that, right? After the experience column, you people will mention miscellaneous, like you can have all these points as achievements. Achievements are like what you achieved, what titles have you been able to get, what have you been able to, what awards have you got. Okay, so maybe you might have been the captain of the football team in your university level. You might have been the editor in chief of your school university magazine. You might have been the best student of the college or of the school. So whatever your achievements were there, you can mention them. And in the end, you can mention their enclosures also. Enclosed certificate of best student award, for example. After achievements, you can mention your hobbies. Your hobbies can be anything: reading or trekking or traveling or listening or singing, whatever. But try to mention the active hobbies. Then finally, it will be the strengths. In the strength column, you can mention like what professional strengths have you got. If you're you can be the one with very good communication skills. You can be the one with very advanced computer skills. Okay, so anything. So what do you think, like it would be suitable for your job profile, you can mention that. And finally, you'll come to the references. That is very important segment. What references you'll mention? References. Here you'll be mentioning name, designation, and the institution. Very important. Mr. K. L. Verma, principal, DK Memorial College, Dehradun. Is that clear? So name, principal, institution, DK Memorial College, Dehradun. Okay, this person you might have either studied, you might have been his student, or you might have worked. This person can be the boss, this person can be your principal or teacher. So mention at least two references are must. Okay, two references you are to give with name, designation, and institution, and even phone numbers. Okay, phone numbers or even email IDs also you can give of these people, so that this recipient, the person whom you are writing this letter, that person can call him or get information about you from him. And afterwards you'll be declaring. Declaration, very important, children. In the declaration part, you will mention like whatever you have stated in the letter, that is all true. And finally, place and date. Place, mention, for example, you are writing letter from Dehradun, mention Dehradun and date, whatever the date is on that particular date. That is the end of your bio data, and cover letter plus bio data makes it application for job. Mind it. If you miss one thing, then it will be considered as half. That's it. So write down this complete format. I'll be sending you one question today. In the group, you people do that homework.